Hey guys, welcome back in the workshop. Today I'm going to work on 5 collaboration carving knives. I'm going to make all the blades, and Ash and X of Instagram is going to make the handles and leather sheaths for all of these knives. Here you already see me cutting these blades out on the bandsaw. For the steel I choose 01 tool steel and I start with a 3mm thick sheet. Once I have all of the blades cut out roughly on the bandsaw, I switch over to the belt grinder to just clean up the perimeters of the blades a little bit. Now that that is done, I go over to the flat platen on the top of my grinder to clean up the faces, because they have some scratches and all sorts of garbage on the surface that needs to be removed. Now I run the edges of the blades through the grinder. This just gives it a smoother rounding and a good surface for further processing. The shape of the blade area is now complete, so now I go over to the tang and clean that up a little bit more. You see me using a file guide here to guarantee that the ricasso area is completely flat, so you can have a zero gap fit up with the handle. I'm going to do this to all the blades, but don't show it to you because that would be really boring. And this is how the blades look now after all the shaping and filing is done. At that point we decided we wanted to give 3 of the blades a forged finish, so you see me here setting up my forge. Now the first blade goes into the heat. And I made sure not to overheat the blade so it doesn't lose the carbon content. I am using only very light blows with the ball pin hammer because I don't really want to change the shape, only want to texture the surface of the blade. I did this to both blades until I was satisfied with the look of the blade. And then I had to make sure to straighten the blade out again because while forging it very much bent, but that worked out alright in the end. You see me here looking for the bends and then slightly correcting them until the blade is completely straight. I did this to all 3 blades with this finish and after that I normalized them to relieve the stresses that built up. Now I had to clean up the shape again on the grinder just to get it smooth again. And this is how these three knives looked after that. Now I put blue dichem on all the blades and scribed the center line to help me grinding the blades symmetrically later. I should really get a surface plate for that, but for now this piece of plexiglass works out alright. So now on to the actual grinding of the blades. These are very small blades, so I put a file guide on the tank just to help me hold on to them better. For the rough grinding before heat treat, I start out with the 36 grit belt here. I only show you this one knife because it's pretty much the same for all of them, and it would take quite a lot of time to show them all. Okay, now it's time for the heat treatment of all these blades. For that I start out preheating the oil with a piece of random scrap metal. This just helps to cool off the blades in a better curve. Now that the oil is warm, the first blade is going into the forge. Now I look for the color of the blade to get a rough idea about the temperature, and once I think it's close to the right temperature, I touch it with a magnet to see if it is reached a critical temperature or not. Once the magnet doesn't stick to the metal anymore, I heat it up a little bit more and then go to the quench. Then I look if the blade is warped in any way and test if it's hardened with the file. Now that the blades are hardened, I put them into a tempering oven for 2 hours at 200 Celsius. Now I can go to the final grind. For that I start out with a 120 grit belt. It is very important to not overheat the blades now, because this would ruin the heat treatment, so I dunk them in water very often. Once I am very close to the final thinness of the blade, I switch over to a finer belt. It's an A45 Trisec belt, I believe. I have my grinder running on a relatively low speed now, because this reduces the risk of a fatal error, but it also takes a lot longer now. Once the edge is down to a zero thickness, I go over and hand sand the final finish and sharpness of the blade. I try my best to keep the sanding lines parallel to each other. This just gives it a much nicer look. On the blades with the forged finish, the hand sanding is relatively quickly done. On the ones with the polished finish, it takes a lot longer to get that. But I'm going to skip the rest of that now, because nobody wants to really see that. As a last step, I'm going to round the spine of the knife, just so it feels nicer on the thumb when you're carving with it. I should have done that earlier, but I forgot about it, to reduce the risk of destroying the blades, but in the end it worked out alright. And these are the final blades in the end. I hope you guys like them, and I'm really excited to see the handles Ash and Axe is going to put on them.